this.
Okay.
We are here now to show off his new project, the Life and Times of Xavier 28. So
this is my, well, I'll be like Johnny Carson. This is Mike Cavallaro, actually. The artist of the Life and Times of Xavier 28, which actually is not published by this company, whose booth I'm sitting at, Arden Entertainment, but I'm editor-in-chief of Arden Entertainment. And here's our new Flash Gordon anthology. Buy it now. But Mike and I are working on this project called The Life and Times of Xavier 28, which is a story about a superhero who's been around for like 60 years. He's been around since the 40s. It's a story I've wanted to tell for like 25 years. A guy who finally wakes up one day and goes, you know, maybe punching people in the face and dropping buildings on people's heads is not the best way to live. But if you're a guy who's been doing that for 40 years, the idea is, well, how do you change? And then what do? And if you still want to impact the world and change the world in a positive way, what do? And it's a sort of a Citizen Kane structure that jumps back in time. It might go from 1940 to 2001, from, you know, Pearl Harbor to 9/11, as we follow him on this journey. It's a story, but I haven't been this excited about a comic book project in years. Except, of course, for the Merlin prophecies coming soon from Arden Entertainment.
What, is this a limited or is this an ongoing?
Limited series, yeah.
All right, excellent. When's this coming out?
First issue comes out in March.
We'll be keeping an eye out for it.
See, I'm not as funny when Tom DeFalco's not here.
You're a lot more animated than last time, though. Last time you just sort of sat there while Tom DeFalco sort of like overpowered the entire apparatus. So,
well,
thank
Tom,
you.
Tom is uncontrollable, but we have him on medication now when he's fine.
Well, thank God for the good people of New York City. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Good luck.
What do you want?